Hello everybody and welcome back to My Life in Taiwan, the channel where I, Alan, attempt to share some of the more interesting aspects of my life as a foreigner here in the beautiful country of Taiwan. Whether that's getting bitten by a killer shrimp, learning foreign languages from fellow Waiguo YouTubers, or indeed asking some of the pertinent questions regarding life here on this beautiful little island.
Is Taiwan wealthy?
And let's not forget that I'm not only present here on YouTube, I also have a pretty interesting Instagram where I share some of my daily life, a little more informal things there. If you want to go check that out, it's Life in Taiwan 2017. Link in the description and you know the rest. But anyway, yes, as I mentioned, I do enjoy discussing some of the more serious topics that affect life here in Taiwan. So what are we here to talk about today? Stress and pressure, and whether or not it affects the Taiwanese people as much as it does some other countries around the world. And the reason that we're going to talk about it is because recently I read an online study about the topic by insurance company Cigna, who discovered that Taiwan is in second position in the world when it comes to high levels of stress. Now, before I give you some of the other countries' results, and indeed tell you which was the only other country in the world to position higher in the list than Taiwan, I'm going to invite you to take a guess. Pause the video, write in the comment section, which countries do you think have high stress levels similar to that of Taiwan, and indeed, which country was the one that finished top of the list with the highest stress levels in the world. And then I'll update you and give you the correct answers later. Because firstly, what I want to do is give you my opinion as to why I agree with this survey and why I think Taiwan's population is overly stressed. Now, to be completely honest, the survey itself cannot be classed as overly comprehensive. Firstly, because it only sampled 23 countries from around the world, and perhaps more significantly, it was sponsored and carried out by a health insurance company whose main goal and driving factor is to encourage its customers to buy more health insurance. So scaring people into thinking that they are more stressed and more vulnerable to illness than they may actually be is within the interests of their company. Therefore, I take this 55.3 stress rating score that they gave Taiwan somewhat with a pinch of salt. But the reason that I mention the survey here is that it does kind of back up my belief that Taiwanese people are overly stressed, or at least they put themselves under too much pressure for what I would consider to be relatively little reward. The average salary here is 40,000 to 50,000 Taiwanese dollars, depending on who you ask, which of course isn't great when we compare it to that of Western countries, but it gets even worse when you consider how hard some Taiwanese people are working for this money. But what I really want to get into on this video is this high stress level in Taiwan, where it comes from, especially relating to the culture and how culture affects the stress levels compared to my culture from back in the UK, and of course, the serious health implications that it puts onto the population here. So let's get into some of those big cultural differences between here in Taiwan and the UK, which has led to this big difference in stress levels found in this survey that actually put England above average in 13th place with a score of 62.5. And one of the big reasons for this is something that as a teacher I see on a daily basis, and that's because I believe in Taiwan, stress starts from a very early age. It might be somewhat anecdotal evidence and just based on my personal experience, but I'm pretty sure that I didn't even know what stress and pressure was until I entered university at 18 years old and had to start paying bills, washing my own clothes, and generally learning how to be an adult. Up until then, yes, I'd worked, I'd had a job, a paper round, a milk route, worked in some supermarkets, but all of the money that I earned was pretty much just pocket money for me, and by no stretch of the imagination was I contributing to the family, nor did I feel any financial burden from my parents. Also, they never gave me any pressure to pass any exams, study for tests, that was all off my own bat. I even chose my own private school for secondary school and did my own thing to get there. My parents, genuinely, I can't remember them ever giving me any pressure at all to study. But here, the kids are fully aware of stress and they feel it every single day. Kids just shouldn't be feeling any pressure like this. The Antrim Band teachers at my school in each class have 20 to 30 of these kids, and the teachers themselves are also under pressure from the parents to get the homework done before the kids go home. It's an absolute cauldron or volcano of stress that often ends up with one of the kids just breaking down. And that's just the elementary school kids. I don't really see many of the high school kids, but I can only imagine that the pressure and stress continues to increase throughout their junior and senior high school, either until one of the kids snaps and has a breakdown, or, like most Taiwanese people, they just learn to accept it and learn to deal with the stress, bottle it up, build it up inside, and then again, as I mentioned, that's only going to have serious health implications. It's absolutely heartbreaking for me to see these young elementary school aged kids going home from my bushy band at 8, 9, 10 o'clock at night after spending all evening writing their homework, or indeed maybe cramming for their all too frequent exams, which seem to be permanently on the horizon, only to know that they've got to come back and do it all again the next day, 5 days a week, and possibly for some of them, 6 or 7 days a week. So yeah, the fact that stress and pressure are such an integral part of childhood here in Taiwan means that it just becomes the norm throughout adult life. But anyway, on to the next reason for the high levels of stress here in Taiwan. And I feel that this comes from this high pressure cooker cauldron that combines the high density living within the cities with the fact, the cultural fact that a lot of Taiwanese families still all live together under one roof. First of all, I know that if I lived with my mother-in-law, or indeed if William's mum lived with my mum, that there would be fireworks. Maybe not often, and maybe not big fireworks, but there would be fireworks. And luckily for us Westerners, we don't have to worry about keeping our face, keeping all of this stress and pressure under wraps. We can usually have a bit of a Barney, make a small apology, and then everything settles back down. Here in Taiwan, of course, there is this big culture of face, which basically means you cannot offend or upset anyone, cannot let yourself look like you're losing your cool. Not to mention, of course, how living in such close quarters with other family members must make certain stress-relieving conjugal activities much more difficult to participate in, shall we say. All of these things combined are, of course, eventually gonna lead to a buildup of stress or pressure within people. Okay, and one more thing I really wanna add about this working culture is that here in Taiwan, most workers will do whatever it takes just to please their boss. Taiwanese people are incredibly polite, respectful, and obedient to their superiors. Whether that's their grandparents at home or indeed their boss at work, they will always do as they are told and try to follow the rules. Whether that's working overtime unpaid, taking on more projects, or indeed attending social events, Taiwanese people will put themselves under stress and pressure just to appease their boss. This just leads to a buildup of stress and pressure with very few ways to relieve it. So what does this actually mean for Taiwan? Well, to get a little bit serious here, it must be worth mentioning that Taiwan has a relatively high suicide rate of 16.5 people per 100,000 population. If you think about my YouTube channel, 78% of the subscribers are Taiwanese, which, let's round that down to 100,000, then the possibility that 16 or more than 16 of my subscribers are at risk of suicide, it's absolutely frightening to think that such a high number of people are putting themselves under such a high amount of stress that it puts Taiwan's suicide ranking into the top 20 countries in the world. And yes, I am aware that suicide isn't always directly related to stress, but it's certainly something that needs to be considered, especially when we take a look at this list that I asked you to guess earlier of the top 5 stressed out countries. And as you can see, South Korea is the only country that is more stressed than Taiwan. And it's not just in this list where South Korea rank higher than Taiwan, because unfortunately, Korea also has a higher suicide rate than Taiwan, with something like 20.5 suicides per year for every 100,000 of the population. Therefore, there is almost certainly some kind of link between the two, a link that I'm by absolutely no means qualified to explore in detail, other than to say that I wish and hope that anybody who's watching my channel that feels on the edge because of stress can go get the help that they need. I absolutely don't want this video to sound anything like preachy or as if I know the answers to anything. That's definitely not the case. But I do know that finding something that makes you happy, whether that's teaching or making YouTube videos such as I have done, then you should definitely be pursuing that thing at all costs. I know it's easier said than done, but it's definitely what I'm doing with this channel. Having an absolutely great time sharing my life and my views with you, the team VVVIP. I think I've said all I've got to say on this topic. Therefore, I'm gonna wrap this video up and say goodbye. As for now, and as always, I'll see you next time in my life in Taiwan. Peace.